One of the questions I get often as a fertility expert is this. Since fertility medications get multiple eggs to develop at once, will this cause a person to run out of eggs sooner? Or the opposite, will using birth control pills to block ovulation save more of your eggs for when you are older? Stay tuned and I will answer these interesting questions. First, some basic biology. Eggs are produced in the ovaries while a person is a fetus. Initially, the number of eggs in the ovaries increases up to a few million. But about 3 months before birth, all egg production stops. After this time, no new eggs will be formed in the ovaries. Therefore, the number of eggs in the ovaries is finite. Ovulation starts in most people during puberty around age 13. During the first few years, ovulation can be sporadic, with an egg being released on some months but not others. After those first few years, things settle down and most people will then release an egg every month. There are times, however, when an egg will not be ovulated. For example, if a person is taking a medication which suppresses ovulation, such as birth control pills, ovulation will mostly not occur. Athletes, especially runners and dancers, will also commonly stop ovulating. Ovulation is also interrupted during a pregnancy or after while a person is nursing. Menopause occurs when only a few dozen eggs remain in the ovaries. The average age of menopause in the United States is about 50. No more eggs are released from the ovaries after menopause. Ovulation is permanently stopped. If you do the math, you will notice that the numbers do not make sense. If a 26-week fetus has 2 million eggs, and one egg is released every month from age 13 until age 50, when essentially all of the eggs are gone, that is only about 444 eggs. What happened to the rest? The truth is that the vast majority of eggs are not lost due to ovulation, they are lost to degeneration. Doctors call this oocyte atresia. This process of losing eggs starts at about 20 weeks before birth. At the time of birth, only about 200,000 eggs remain in the ovaries. During the ovulation years, one egg is typically released every month, but that egg comes from a larger group of eggs called a cohort. The size of the cohort can be somewhere around 60 to 100 eggs. This large group of eggs starts to mature because of the hormones being produced from the pituitary gland. Because of the changing hormone levels and the differing sensitivity of the eggs to those hormones, some eggs will stop developing. Just before ovulation occurs, usually only one egg is left, which will then be released, but the rest of that cohort will then degenerate. Fertility medications work by changing the hormone dynamics so that more than one egg will mature. In other words, the fertility medications are salvaging some of the eggs that would otherwise have been lost due to degeneration. The reverse is true for people that are not ovulating. The same number of eggs will still degenerate during that time, whether a person ovulates one egg or not. This is why people who use birth control pills or have several pregnancies still go through menopause at the same age as those who haven't. Fertility medications do not cause a person to run out of eggs faster. Does anything else cause the number of eggs to drop more rapidly? Yes. There are several factors that accelerate the rate of degeneration. The most common is cigarette smoking. Exposure of the ovaries to chemotherapy or radiation can also accelerate the loss of eggs, and of course, surgery to remove part or all of the ovary will also result in less eggs. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: do not worry. The use of fertility medications will not cause you to run out of eggs any faster. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.